Today I am out in southern France, southeastern France, and I'm looking for France's most venomous scorpion. You might be able to tell, a lot of this is burned, so it may be tougher to find them in some areas, but where it's still quite natural, should definitely be possible. Ah, here it is. This is Buthus occitanus, the most venomous scorpion in France. But I'd like to point out that even though this is the most venomous scorpion species in France, out of the five, I believe, it still isn't lethal to healthy adult humans. There's another one right there. I should also mention that not only are these the most venomous scorpions we have in France, but they're also the largest.
A little Moorish gecko, Tarantula mauritanica. And this one appears to be near melanistic because of how dark it is.
So down here, underneath this rock, we actually have a Buthus occitanus. Not sure if you can see it. That's its tail right there. I'm not sure if this goes back any further. I don't know. Behind, I can't see so clearly. I'm gonna try to poke it out. Anyway, there's the scorpion right there. I widened the burrow just a little bit. You know, no harm to the scorpion. And there it is. I won't bother it too much. But there you have it. Yellow scorpion.
Mediterranean recluse spider right here. Loxosceles, I forget the last name. One of the more dangerous spiders here in France, but even then, not really all that venomous.
Oh, that's quite a large one right there. An interesting thing about this species is that it lives in France, in Spain, parts of the Middle East, and North Africa, but its venom toxicity isn't the same throughout all of these regions. In France, they have supposedly the least toxic venom. Meanwhile, in North Africa and the Middle East, it tends to be much more toxic. The venom toxicity here in France is lower than that of the Middle East and North Africa by a factor of 3 to 4.
Buthus down here.
Two groups of Buthus occitanus, this scorpion right here, were used to determine venom toxicity. One group is labeled as South France, and it was collected in 1981. And the other one is labeled as Mediterranean, which is quite ambiguous. So in conclusion, if you were stung by one of these in North Africa, it will hurt much more than it will in France. And I'm not quite sure what the data would be for Spain, which also has this species. A little Timon lepidus, or ocelid lizard, from under this rock. And this one is just a baby. This is France's largest lizard species. It's also called the jeweled lacerda.
Another Buthus occitanus. And this one is an adult male, I believe. While the last one was an adult female. Yeah. You can tell it has a smaller body. And there you have it. Going down another hole that doesn't belong to it. I'll try to save it. Redirecting this one back into its hole so don't crush it. Almost there. Come on, that way. There you go.
A little crocodile gecko, or Moorish gecko, Tarantula mauritanica, found under this rock. Although, originally it was from this rock, and it dashed over. You can see this one has tiny little orange parasites there too. Anyway.
Right here is the telson of Buthus occitanus. This is a subadult right here. Male European mantis here, a yellow one.
Here, as opposed to the last scorpion, is an adult Buthus occitanus. And it actually may be gravid too, but here's my hand for size reference.
Another Buthus under this rock here.
Right down there. There is a scorpion. I've been successful in poking it out. And there you have it. This is the second non-adult I've seen, which is kind of surprising. Not many juveniles today.
Just caught this Malpolon monspecialinus, or the Montpellier snake. And it was under this log. It's very unhappy with me. And I'm not going to grab it, like, at the midsection of its body because I don't want to get bitten. This snake is venomous.
Back under your log you go.
It's So under this rock, we have this large Buthus occitanus, yellow scorpion. And over here, it looks like this telson right here is fresh enough and not hollow to be some other scorpion's telson. That means there was some cannibalism that went on here. There's other pieces here. And this right here is older. So this scorpion may have been busy eating many scorpions in its life.
Here we have a conehead mantis, Empusa pinnata. In my opinion, one of Europe's coolest mantis species. Or more like the coolest mantis genus we have. Supposedly, these are supposed to be rather uncommon, but I've had no trouble finding them. Just on this trip alone, I've seen more than 10 so far. This one is not an adult, by the way. Adults have rather long wings and are capable of flight. I would have shown you this one camouflaging in whatever plant it was living on, but I actually found this one just sitting on my shoulder. Really not quite sure how it got there or when. I'm elated to see this particular individual here because we're in a burn zone and this species is quite fragile. So that means that the utheca or the egg cases survived the fire. And in addition to this, this is the only individual of this species that I've ever seen in this region.
Putting this little mantis in this bush, close enough to being her color. If she wants to move, she can. Here we have another Buthus occitanus. This one actually has a good burrow. Goes back. You can see the end of it though. The legs poking out.
Oh, this one's really small. This is the smallest one I've seen all day. Moorish gecko here, trying to bite me from under this rock. Seems to be a lot of them out here, which is quite unsurprising. Back you go.
Yellow scorpion right here. Quite a large one. Adult female.
Well, that will be all for this video. So, thank you for watching.